parentheses, we're gonna go over. That's the ones. So we're gonna do multi-step, and then we're gonna go into the ones with parentheses. Okay. So don't worry. Okay. All right. So we have here. Let me know. Is it recording? Hi. Welcome to period 6, math 1. Okay. So here we go. We have negative 35 less than or equal to negative 9m minus 8, right? So we have our inequality river, and our goal is to get m by itself, right? Our goal is to get m by itself. So we got to undo the order of operation, right? We take the inverse operation to help us solve for it. So the inverse operation, I see there's a subtraction. So the inverse operation is an addition. So we're going to add 8 to both sides of the equation to cancel out the negative. And when we're just adding, what's going to happen to our inequality? Adding and subtracting. Do we change the sign? Do we need to? No. It stays the same. You bring down the negative 9n, right? What's negative 35 plus 8? Negative what? 27. Yeah, I agree. Okay. Next, what we have is there a multiply or divide to get m by itself? That we need to do for ourselves. We need to divide. Yeah, there's a hidden multiplication. We need to divide both by negative 9. Wait. Bing, 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 bing. Something went, alarm went off. Alarm went off. I divide by a negative. Divide by a negative. When I divide by a negative, what's happening to my inequality sign? Yeah, you need to flip it immediately so you don't forget. And then our negative 9 over negative 9 cancels out. You're just left with n. And then negative divided by a negative, that's a positive. 27 divided by 9 is a 3, right? But the thing is, do we like it in this format where we have it 3 goes first in the math sentence? No, we need to mirror it. Exactly. So let's go ahead and mirror that. So n goes first. Our inequality gets flipped once more. And then 3 goes last. So our final answer is actually n is less than or equal to 3. Do we have that answer? N is less than or equal to 3. So this is just asking you to solve for the variable n. Do you guys know how to graph and how to check your answer? Do you want to learn that? Okay, so if we want to learn how to graph, there are several questions we got to ask ourselves. You guys remember the question that we have to ask ourselves? What's the first one? Where's our starting point? Nope, not close or open. Starting point. Close or open will come in a little bit. Yeah. What's our starting point? 3. Yeah, so we start at 3. And then you have a couple values to the left and right of the 3. So 4 and 5, 2 and 1. Right? What's the next question now that we have the starting point is at 3? What's the next question? Close. You forgot. Arrow. Which way is the arrow pointing before the open and close circle? Which way is the arrow? It's going to the left because we have a less than symbol, right? So we have a less than symbol. then it's going to the left. You can do it on the number line itself, or you can do it right above the number line. And then we ask ourselves, is it open or closed circle? Is there no equal sign, or is there equal sign? It's a closed circle because we have an equal sign here. So it's a closed circle. We're going to have a closed circle on 3. And then you need to check one more thing. What was the last question that we need to check? The variable is on the left of the sentence, right? At the beginning of the sentence. And we do. We have N right there, right? So we know we can shade everything to the left. So that's how you graph. Did we go over how to check your work before? Have we gone over that for this period? Remind me. So did you guys know how to check your work? Okay, so let's check your work. What's the first step when you check your work? You gotta use the what? Yeah, you gotta plug in your answer and use the original inequality to plug in your answer, okay? So negative 35 less than or equal to. Sorry, my computer is overheating. Okay, negative 9n minus 8. What are we going to substitute in for our n? We have to pick any values from 3 or below. You want to pick 3? Yes, you can pick 3, n equal to 3. You know what's my favorite one? I thought I'd share with you guys. My favorite is 0. Okay, and I'll show you why I to pick 0. Okay, so let's do the one that you have first. You say you want to replace n with 3. Everything else stays the same, so everything else comes down. And we're going to check to see if it's less than 35. Negative 35 is less than that. Okay, by the way, there's a hidden multiplication. So all we did is we found our n equal to 3 because it's on our value, right? Right here, it's on our value. Any of our solution set will work. Anything, any value. So we can technically pick 2, pick 1, pick 0, pick negative 1,000. Doesn't matter. You pick the one that you like the most. Okay. So let's continue to check. Oops. Let me use the correct color. Negative 35, is that less than or equal to, what's negative 9 times 3? Negative what? 27, right? Mm-hmm. Minus 8 more. So negative 35, is that less than or equal to, wait, what's negative 27 minus 8 more? Negative 35, yeah, mm-hmm. So in this case, what we have here is we have negative 35 is equal to, right? Remember, this is an equal sign, equal to negative 35. So this is a true statement. So if it's a true statement, then our solution set here, solution set is true, is valid, or is correct. So this solution set is referring to this one right here, okay? The graph, and also to our answer right here. Okay, we're good? Can I show you why I like 0? So you have the same thing, negative 35, less than or equal to, and you're checking negative 9, oops, let me do a better job, times my favorite, to substitute in for n is 0. As long as 0 is in the solution set, and it is right here, 0 is in our solution set. Remember, it's anything that's along this inequality, right? Minus a, sorry, don't forget the minus a. So what happens when you have negative 9 times 0? What is that? Anything times 0 is 0, right? Minus 8. What's 0 minus 8? Negative 8, right? And on number line, right, if we continue the number line, negative 8 is over here, negative 9, negative 10, blah, blah, blah. And negative 35 is all the way over here, right, not drawn to scale. So we have actually that negative 35 is less than negative 8, which is also a true statement. So that means the solution set is also correct. So true. Okay, so we showed you how to solve for n, right? We don't stop there. We flip it, use the mirror image, right? We showed you how to graph using these four steps. So this is your final answer right here. And we show you how to check your work by substituting it into the original inequality, which is right here. You can use any value that is on your solution set. Okay, so you can use 3, you can use 0, you can use negative 1,000, I don't care. As long as it's in your solution set and you prove it. Okay. Any questions about this? How to solve for n, how to graph, how to check your work? I got one thumbs up in the Paradeck. I got, that means you're good to go. I got a couple feedback in the chat. Most of you guys are good on this. So can we move on to the one that has a little parentheses on there? Okay, let's go ahead and do that. And let me set it all full screen. Whoops, wrong one. Click over here. Okay, so let's move on over to this crazy one. Let's do 25 first, and if you want another example, I can show you another example. Okay, here we go. And if you want to do it along with us in the Paradeck, you can. All right, so what we have here is we have 3 times, there's a hidden multiplication anytime between the quantity, right, greater than or equal to negative 108. So whatever's inside the quantity, so we say, not parentheses, we say quantity of, so if you want to be a better mathematician or a better sounding mathematician, you say quantity of for this parentheses, okay? So 3 times the quantity of 5x minus 6, all of that is greater than or equal to negative 108. So let's go ahead and set up our inequality river. There's 2 methods to do this. I'll show you both. The first one is distribution. Oops. Okay, the second one is, just using our good old order of operation. You choose which one you like the most. So I'm gonna name it order of operation backwards. Okay, or undo order of operations. Wait, what are they called? Use inverse operation, sorry. Inverse operations. Distribution or distributive property. Can't spell. Okay, what happens with distributive property is you just distribute this 3 into the parentheses to 5x and also to negative 6. What's 3 times 5x? Yeah, 15x. What's 3 times negative 6? Negative 18. okay? And then all this, we just distribute it. We haven't done anything. Once you finish your distributive property, you still need to use your good old order of operations backwards when you're solving for this X, okay? So undo the order of operations. So first question I'm gonna ask you is there any addition and subtraction that we need to do the opposite operation, the inverse operation of? Yeah, what do we need to do? Add 18, yeah, exactly. We're gonna add 18 to both sides. What happens when we add 18 to both sides? This side cancels out, you're left with 15x. Do we do anything to our inequality symbol? When we're just adding and subtracting? No, right? Stays the same. What about negative 108 plus 18? What do we have? Negative 90. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Good. Negative 90. So we're done adding, check. Now, is there any multiply and divide? What do we need to do? Divide by 15 on both sides. Yes. So divide by 15. Wait. If I divide by 15, am I doing anything to our inequality symbol? No, because we didn't divide by a negative. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. So it stays the same. The 15 cancels. X is greater than or equal to what's negative 90 divided by 15? Is that negative 6? Yeah. Sorry, I was doing mental math. Okay. So that's the first step or first method. Okay. Second method, when you do the inverse operations, is just this. Okay. It's just this. We're just going to follow this idea and we'll start the same way. 3 times the quantity of 5x minus 6. So I'm just showing you the second method. You can pick and choose whichever way you like, and I should draw a demarcation between method one and method two, okay? So that's my demarcation, squiggly line. Okay, so order of operation tells us that if we have parentheses, right? If we have, let me put a different color. I'll put highlighter. If we have a parentheses right here, we do that last. We don't even touch anything inside of it at all. Okay, we don't touch anything inside of it at all. But on the outside, what do we have? Do we have any addition and subtraction that we need to do? We have addition and subtraction outside of the parentheses. We have a subtraction inside the parentheses, but we can't touch that until we get to the parentheses step. So technically, we do not have any addition and subtraction outside of the parentheses. Yeah. What about multiply and divide? Do we have any multiply or divide outside of the parentheses that we need to undo and take the inverse operation of? What do we need to do here? Yes, we need to divide because it is a multiply by 3. So we need to divide both sides by 3. So what happens when you divide by 3? We're left with 5x minus 6 on the left. When we divide by 3, what happens to our inequality symbol? Does it stay or does it flip? It stays because it's positive, right? We're not dividing by a negative. What about negative 108 divided by 3, what is that reduced down to? Negative 16? Can somebody double check? I could. All right, you can use the scientific calculator. Put that in the chat. in case you need it. Negative 108 divided by 3. Negative 36. Oh, wait. I was way off. I don't know why I was thinking 16. Okay. I got the 6. Yeah, negative 36. Okay. Next question is there any exponential? No, I don't see any, right? What about parentheses? We do have a parenthesis we need to take off, right? So you just take off and become this. Okay, and then you basically cycle back and you do it again. Okay, so cycle back and you do it again. Is there any addition and subtraction? Yeah, so what do we need to undo? The subtraction with what? Yeah, add 6 to both sides. So when you add 6 to both sides, that cancels out. You're left with 5x. Wait a minute, what happens to our inequality sign here? Does it stay or does it flip? It stays the same because it's just adding and subtracting. What about negative 36 plus 6? I get negative 30. Good. Okay, so done with that adding of 6. Is there any multiply and divide? What do we need to do? Yeah, there's a hidden multiplication, so what do we need to do? Divide both sides by 5. Exactly. When you divide both sides by 5, what's happening here? X is greater than or equal to, what's negative 30? Divide by 5. Because we divide by a positive, we don't change an inequality sign. I get what? Negative 6, right? So it doesn't matter if you like the method 1 using distributive property or method 2 using the inverse operation right here. You get the same answer. You choose which one you like more. I don't care. I show you both. Can you let me know in the Pear Deck and or in the chat? Do you like method 1 or method 2? Distributive property, inverse operation. Okay, can you tell me why? Let me put it into the paradigm. Can you tell me why you like your method? Like, I like method 1 because, here, let me give you a text prompt really quick. Because, and tell me the reasoning. Why do you like that method? Okay. So some of you guys understand it better using a certain method. So you choose that one. Some people like the shorter version because it looks like method 1 is a little bit shorter. Sure. Method 1 is faster. First method. Are you going to remember to distribute though when you see that? Or I don't know, because I know some people in the other periods, they like the inverse operation because they just cycle through and make sure they do this the whole time. Because with distribution, they have, you know, have to remember to distribute that and then use that. So it's up to you. This period, it seems like a lot of you guys like method 1. Good for you. Okay, good. All right, so can I give you one so you try it on your own? Because I think this one was a tricky one that a lot of people missed. I think now you know what to do, right? So go ahead and try this one, number 28. I'll put it on the next slide. I'll enlarge it in a second. And those of you who want to do it in the Pear Deck, so I can check your work, you can do it in the Pear Deck. Okay, give yourself about 3 minutes head start, and I'll go over any questions you have. If you need to type it up, you can type it up. Those of you who are writing with a very thick pen, I recommend that you thin it out a little bit so you have a little bit more space to show your work on Pear Deck. Yeah, yeah. You got it. Some of you guys are faster with typing, so that's good. Good, good. Beautiful, beautiful. Good job, Adam. Keep going. You're on the right track. Good, good, good. Very nice, Joanna. Definitely on the right track. You don't have to show me intermediate step, Joanna. Just keep going because I know you could do it. I see it. What is 2.5 a number? I don't know. Sorry. Oh, the lesson? Oh. Great question. Those of you who are doing that, let me see. Where is it? It's on a puzzle, right? It tells you what the title is in the hang on, let me show you. 6 period. 2.5, solving compound inequality. So now, after you are comfortable solving one inequality, now we're going to have two. And we're going to talk about that next week. But if you are having trouble with it, don't worry. Watch the video again and again. Until you understand. Yeah. Yeah. Because she explains it very well in the video. She gives you two type of the compounds that we're going to talk about. We're going to have some math and English lesson. English and math. And you're like, what? Missing those two subjects does not connect. Yeah, they do. Very good, Ava. Oh, sorry. Forgot one more thing, Joanna. When you have that negative 2, you got to remember, those of you who are doing the distribution, I forgot. You don't just distribute that negative 2 to the first one. You got to also make sure you distribute to the second one too. Okay? So, Joanna, can you go back and fix that really quick? I missed that one. Adam... Yes, I think so. Ava is almost there. Ava Roback, keep going. Beautiful, Liliana. Very good. The birthday girl is awesome. Okay. Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to lock screen here. Let me share with you what some of the people did. There you go. Cheryl response. So this person did distribution, right? So they distribute the negative 2 into the parentheses, the quantity of x plus 2. So negative 2 times x, you get negative 2x. Negative 2 times 2, you get negative 4. Everything else just bring down, right? Add 4 to both sides to solve for x. We don't change the sign because it's just adding. Oh, I forgot plus sign here. But they added. They added because they got 18. And then you're left with negative 2x is less than 18. And then you divide both sides by 2. When you bing, 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 divide by negative 2, you change the sign right away. So you get x is greater than negative 9. And we see that several times, right? Plus 4, divide by 2, change the sign immediately, right? Change the sign immediately. So these are great questions and great examples I'm going to use this one because it's in color. And I think colors help you guys a lot. So if it helps you, please, please use it. Ta-da. I locked the screen before you were done. Sorry. You're good. I unlocked it. Okay. Good, good, good. Yay. Yay. Okay, very good. I see a lot of x's greater than negative 9. Good, good, good. Okay, so how about this? How do we feel about this? I just want to make sure that was the hard one that you guys missed. Got 10 people that got it correct, 16 people didn't. Do you want me to help you with graphing a little bit more? Or do you just want to go and play? You let me know. Uh-oh, some people still need help. What do you need help with? Graph. Okay, that I agree. I agree. I think graphing is very important because we see that again and again. Match the graph with the correct inequality, right? So, hang on. Let's do this. Let me zoom in. So this one got 46%. So let's practice graphing a little bit more. Okay, let's practice graphing a little bit more. Should we graph the last one? Should we graph this one so you can practice looking at it from this one and then we can see it from this one? Okay, let's do that. Okay, so if you wanna do along with us in the Pear Deck so I can check your work, you are welcome to. Okay, so this one was just solving, right? So we are going to graph this one right here. So when you're graphing, what happens? What's the first question you gotta ask yourself when you're graphing? Yes, we'll help you with fraction. Can you let me know which problem? Yeah, what's the center or what's your starting point, right? So our starting point is going to be what? What's our starting point? Yeah, -9, right? So -9 is our starting point. And you're going to pick a couple values to the left and right of it. So -8, -7, -6, if you like to do it that way. I noticed some of you guys like to do it this way too. Let me show you. Those of you who are showing me your work on the other side. Yeah. So some people, they like to do this. They like to do -9 and then they have the center at 0. Or actually, let me do it this way. So they center at 0, but then they have -9 on this side, and then they show 9 on the other side. Make sure there's equal distance apart, okay? So that way you know those are tick marked correctly. Okay, so either way is fine. So we have -9 as our starting point. Sure. What's the second question that we ask ourselves? Uh-huh. Arrows. Which directions, right? Which direction are we going to have it? To the right? Because it's a what? It's a greater than sign, right? So we can do to the right. Okay. And third question? What's our third question? Open or... close circle, which one? No equal to sign, or is there equal to sign? No equal to sign, right? There's nothing, so it's an open circle, good. So open circle on -9. And then we check to see if variable is on the left of your math sentence, right? And it is, right? There's your X right here. So we can shade it all the way in. Shade it all the way in. Okay, so either way is fine as long as you can see it for yourself. If you want to do a couple of values to the left and right, or if you want to do the center at zero and then have -9 on there so you can see it. Very good, very good. I see a lot of great graphs. Mm-hmm. Do we need to check? Do we need help with checking, or are you guys good? So can you let me know? I have a couple people let me know in the chat. Are we good? Thumbs up. And you like, you can go play now. Or do you want me to go and show you how to check one more time? Sure, sure, sure. Okay, we have a couple people. Let's just help them really quick to check their work. Okay, check your work. What's the first thing you gotta do for checking your work? Use the what? Original inequality, right? So -2 times the quantity x plus 2 less than 14. And what are we going to pick for our x? What should we pick for our x? Yes, we will do a fraction with that, sure. What are we gonna pick for our x? You can use any of these that are in our solution set. So what should we pick for our x? The easiest one, come on, easiest one. Is what? You want to use -6? You can certainly use -6. You can use -7. You can use -8. Can you use -9? No. Okay. You can certainly use x equal to 0 because 0 is here. I'm going to tell you, for this one, x equals to -2 is actually going to be the easiest. Why? I have -2 times the whole entire quantity, right? I'm checking to see if it's less than 14. Why do you think I picked -2 this time instead of 0? We can certainly do 0. Sure, let's do 0. And then let's, and I'll show you why I picked -2. This time. Only this time. Okay, so let's simplify. What happens when you get it? We gotta do whatever's inside the parentheses when we're simplifying, right? So -2 times what when we're simplifying? 0 plus 2 is 2, right? What's -2 times 2? -4. Is that less than 14? Is that a true statement? It is true, right? So that we know our solution set is correct. Why do you think I pick -2 this time? When I see an x, I substitute in a -2 instead of 0. Why do you think I do that? Well, let's see. -2 times, what's -2 plus 2? What's -2 plus 2? Zero, right? And what's -2 times 0? Zero, right? Is 0 less than 14? Is that a true statement? Check. Also true statement. So that means the solution is correct. Okay. So you have to pick. Sometimes, yes, 0 will work wonder for you. Okay. 0 will work wonder for you when you substitute in. But you have to look at what's around it, right? Right, when you're checking your work. Okay, so I hope that with the graph a little bit, it can help you. And then let's go ahead and try this other graph before we dive into the fraction really quick. So they want you to match the graph right here. You're welcome to do it in the Pear Deck with us as well. So they want you to match the graph with the inequality. So right here, what's your starting point? Do they all have the same starting point? 2.75, 2.75, 2.75, 2.75? Yeah, sure. That's the first question you ask. What's the second question you ask again? Which way is it going, right? So the arrow is going to point to the right, which is a greater than symbol. And what was the third question that we asked ourselves? Is it open or closed circle? Okay, so if it's an open circle, then it's no equal sign underneath. If it's closed circle, there is equal sign. So it's an open circle, so we don't have anything down here. Okay, and the last question is, where's the variable? You gotta be on the left of your math sentence, right? So you can use X. I think they use D here, so we'll try to match them, D. But is any of these sentences starting with D? Did they start with a D? No, right? So we have to do one more thing, right? We have to do what? Mirror it, right? Exactly. So 2.75. You gotta mirror the inequality symbol as well. So opposite symbol and then D. Which one of this does it look like? Is it A, B, C, or D option? Yeah, B as in boy. Mm-hmm. So does this help? So you got to be able to go forward and backwards on this steps and also on mirroring the image, right? Going forward and backwards. Questions about how to graph? Before we dive into the fraction, I know there was a question about fractions, so I want to get to that one. Okay, I got two thumbs up in the Pear Deck. Some of you guys are still writing, I think. Let me know. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I got some more feedback in the Google Meet. Some more on either both Google Meet and Pear Deck. Good, good, good. Okay, so let's go ahead and check the fractions. Okay, so do I see a fraction? I don't see a fraction yet. Oh, this one? I don't know. Who's the one that's asking for fraction? Oh, he gave me a question. Okay, never mind. So this was a question that one of our students proposed, but I don't know what you mean by that. Do you mean like this J 3/4 is greater than R? Like that? Let me know in the chat and or in the Pear Deck. Okay, good. Okay, so we're going to start off with that. And I'm sorry that it was the wrong pen, so I'm going to use the right pen. J times, right? There's a hidden multiplication, 3/4 greater than R. So we have our inequality here. When you multiply by a fraction, we talked about this. When you multiply by a fraction, you can definitely undo it with division of a fraction. Oh, sorry, I meant divide by a fraction. Okay, divide by a fraction. It is the same as multiply by its reciprocal. Okay, so if you have 3/4, the reciprocal will be what? Four thirds, exactly. So the reciprocal would be 4/3. Okay, so we're going to multiply by 4/3. And you see why we multiply by 4/3 instead of dividing by 3/4. Okay, it's the same thing, okay? So if you notice with fractions, we always multiply across. And 3 times 4 is 12, divided by 4 times 3 is also 12. 12 over 12 is a 1, so that actually cancels out, and you just left with J. And because this is multiplying by a positive number, so all we had to do with the inequality symbol is just bring it down. And then R times 4/3 is often written more like 4/3 R. We usually put the variable last, numbers first. Okay, does that answer your question in particular in terms of fractions? You gotta remember, this is your key here. Dividing by a fraction is same as multiplying by its reciprocal. Okay, so multiply by 4/3 would be a lot easier. Let me know. Did I answer your question? If not, I just ask more questions to follow up. Only one letter? I don't know if I have another one. Are you talking about something like 28 right here? Or 25, like this one, number 19. Okay, sure, let's do that. Okay, so we have, the inequality here, right? And our goal is to get J by itself. And right now, J is being multiplied by -3/4, right? So what you can do here is you could what we just talked about in the previous slide, right? In the previous slide, we talked about dividing by a fraction is the same as multiply by its reciprocal. Because when we have a multiplication, we wanted to divide by -3/4, right? So, but we don't want to do that because then that will make things more complicated. So we want to multiply by its reciprocal. So -3/4, what's the reciprocal of -3/4? -4/3, not just 4/3, but -4/3. The reason why we want -4/3 is that the negative and negative will cancel out, right? I'll leave that there. Okay, so multiply by -4/3. So negative negative will become a positive. 4 and 4 will cancel, become a 1. 3 and 3 will cancel, become a 1. So you literally left with J. Okay. And, oh, wait, hold on. I forgot to ask you. We multiply by a negative on both sides. What's going to happen to our inequality sign? Yeah. Flip it. And then over here, we put over 1, and then we multiply across. What's 12 times -4? negative 48, right? And then denominator, multiply across, 1 times 3 is just 3. Can we reduce that? What's negative 48 divided by 3? Negative 16. How about this now? Are we understanding a little bit more? Mm-hmm. So you just got to remember that dividing by a fraction is the same thing as multiplying by its reciprocal. Right, reciprocal we talked about here. So that's a key. And then the second key is that you gotta remember is that the sign will change if you are multiplying by a negative. Or dividing by a negative. Good? Okay, those of you who have 70% or above, you technically do not have to take it again. So meaning that David, you don't have to take it. Paisley, you don't have to take it. Alondra, you don't have to take it. Maddox, you don't have to take it. Adrian, you don't have to take it. Lily, you don't have to take it. Ava, you don't have to take it. Jaleesa, you don't have to take it. Catherine, you don't have to take it. And Johanna, you're barely there. You don't have to take it. But if you want a better score than whatever you have, then I suggest that you play again. Those of you who I just called that you don't have to take the quiz again, you just need to check out on Pear Deck. Okay, the rest of you, let's play. And let me give you the link one more time. Or you can use the joinmyquiz.com. Give me a second. And then give me one more second for the Pear Deck link. Just give me a second. Scrolling up. You guys participated. This is awesome. I love it. Where's the Jamboard link? Oh, Paradigm link. There we go. Yeah, I will be calling your name out as you check out so that way you can make sure you get your participation points. But again, like I said, the people who are allowed to check out, Elijah, make sure you put your first and last name separate. Make my grading easier. All right, go ahead and get started. And then let me make sure that I got the correct people who are checking out. If you're not done, please don't check out yet. Go and finish your quiz. Do a better job. Your goal is 70% or above, okay? 70% or above. Otherwise, no. You're taking it again until you get a better score, better understanding. Okay, let me make sure I get the right people again. Alondra, you're dismissed. Have a good weekend. Catherine, you're dismissed. Have a good weekend. Ava Roback, you're dismissed. Have a great weekend. Lily, you're dismissed. Have a great weekend, and I'll see you tomorrow. when I drop by at your house to give you your Pikachu. And happy birthday. Easily, congratulations. 100%. You're dismissed. Keep up the good work. Ellen, keep up the good work. 100%. You're dismissed. Have a great weekend. Jaleesa, did you get my email? Let me know. We can also talk about it at hi Adrian. Later at 3:30 too. Okay. Give me a second. Maddox. You're dismissed. Have a great weekend. Good job today. Want me to send that to mom? Do you want me to send that score to mom? Okay. Sounds good. All right. Adrian. Sorry. I was talking to another Adrian. He just came in on the Aviation and Space Club. Just give me a second. Mendez, right? Mendez. Adrian Mendez, have a great weekend. 90%. Keep it up. Ava Espinosa. Ava Roback is dismissed. Ava Espinosa. You need to take it again, please, Ava. Espinosa. David. 100% accuracy. Keep up the good work. David, you're dismissed. Grace. Grace, you need to take it again, please. Allison. Allison, you need to take it again, please. Oh my God, I forgot to stop recording. Sorry. Stop recording now. Bye.